Well, it's enormously important that we still maintain some access to the single market and the customs union. And maintaining that trading basis is going to be enormously important since we're leaving both the single market and the customs union. But making sure that European businesses can still do business in the UK and UK businesses can still trade in Europe is enormously important, and that is going to be the thrust of the negotiations in sorting out that new arrangement that there is going to be. Well, this is really a team effort in the negotiations, and everybody needs to unite together. It's not about individuals, it's all of us coming together to make sure we get the best deal for the UK. And that is what we need to absolutely do. Our Brexit ministers have been doing a really good job. Liam Fox has been going around the world and making sure that we've got lots of new trade deals ready to go upon Brexit with the rest of the world. David Davis is a very well-respected politician in Brussels and known to be a very fair and strong negotiator. So he's going to be doing the best that he can there. And of course, we've got Boris, who's solid as ever in ensuring that Brexit will be taking place and that our diplomatic relations with countries all around the world will be maintained, as well as with the EU. The biggest challenge, of course, is going to be maintaining that access to the single market and the customs union when we've left the European Union and we've left the single market, and ensuring that there are no barriers to trade. We absolutely don't want to see any tariffs put in place. We don't want to see any barriers coming up, be they physical or non-tariff barriers as well. So this is what we need to focus on, and particularly in the case of Northern Ireland, for example, and finding solutions to Northern Ireland, enormously important. So that is really going to be the main thrust of these negotiations, and getting that deal in place is going to be enormously important. And making sure that then from that we build a free trade arrangement with the EU, no model for which exists currently to date, that is comprehensive and allows us to have the least amount of disruption come Brexit. Well, Brexit means that yes, we're leaving the European Union and we will be leaving the single market, but our new comprehensive free trading agreement with the EU that hasn't yet been negotiated will be of great value to us and will build a new relationship that we have with the EU. So we will still be trading with the EU, and that is the aim of our negotiators when they go in that room. But of course, when we leave the European Union, we will get our trading powers back. That will give us the power to go out and create new free trade agreements all around the world. And we already have 9 working groups that are working with 15 different countries in a trade dialogue in order to scope out those new trade deals that we're going to be making all around the world. That's opening up new opportunities for our small and medium-sized enterprises, making them part of global supply chains, putting us back on that global marketplace, and definitely delivering for our consumers as well. More products, more choice, and hopefully at a lower cost. So there is enormous opportunities for us to maintain our trading relationship with the EU, but also be able to have that new opportunity to trade with the rest of the world and truly become a global Britain. Well, our new Department for International Trade is already working hard, gathering the best trade negotiators from all around the world and scoping out the possibilities of new deals. And they really are the world over. Of course, we have natural partners within our Commonwealth family, being in Australia and New Zealand, as well as Canada. But of course, the US and getting a free trade deal with America is enormously important. It's the UK's largest exporter, and that is an enormously important relationship. And it is one that is very, very special. And we're very lucky in that Trump has already said and recommitted to doing a trade deal with the UK, and that is of enormous importance to us. But we are really open to people all around the world. The new emerging markets that we're seeing over in Mexico, there's enormous opportunities for the UK, and building a great FTA with Mexico would be also a great price for us to look into. Well, I'm very upbeat about what may or may not happen after we Brexit, but of course we need to be realistic at the same time. I think whilst the long-term view is extremely positive, there is still some uncertainty around the short-term view, but we haven't seen the big shocks that were predicted after the referendum, and we're seeing record levels of investment coming to the UK. And I think as people now see what our vision for global Britain really is, and that we're we're going to become more competitive, standing on the world stage, becoming more innovative, and regaining our self-confidence as a nation, I think more and more people will come to the UK, which will really knock out any sort of negative downturn that we may see. But we have to be realistic, there may be some short-term problems, but it is absolutely for long-term gain. I think that there is enormous benefits for the UK in becoming the master of its own destiny after Brexit. And we'll feel those benefits both economically, politically and socially. And absolutely it is something that we need to be looking at and with great optimism. And if I can leave everybody watching this video with anything, it is an optimism for the future and to help us build that future together. Everybody has to become an ambassador for our country now. Everybody has to put their shoulders to the wheel to make sure we get the best deal for our country, for future generations, and for new opportunities that are going to set us back on that world stage.